Lion! Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome here to Gardens, the launch of the website of Gardens Rugby Club. I'm Rhys Marman and I will be the MC for the evening. And I would like to call on Mr. Gert Whiteboy to open this gathering with a prayer. Mr. Gert Whiteboy.
Good afternoon or evening. Before I do the short prayer, I just want to read three verses from a psalm. When brothers dwell in unity, behold how good and pleasant it is when brothers dwell in unity. It is like the precious oil on the head running down on the beard of Aaron. It is like the dew of Hermon which falls on the mountains of Zion. For the Lord has commanded the blessing. Life forevermore. Come, let's pray. Close our eyes, we're going to pray. Heavenly Father, we give unto you all honor and praise because you deserve it. We give thanks to you, Lord, because it's you who works in the man, in the heart of man. So I want to say thank you for each and every one who has contributed to make this evening a success. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Whiteboy. We now call on the Senior Vice President of Gardens Rugby, Mr. Rudy Rousseau, to do the official welcome. Mr. Rudy Rousseau.
Let me just greet each and everyone. Good evening, everyone present tonight with us in Agape. On this historic night, it's a new venture. It's something new Gardens is taking on. And then also to all our supporters and rugby public outside who is following us on our live Facebook page. As we have said, this is something totally new to us. And it's a privilege for us to have all of you present with us. And all of this only can happen for what we are standing for as Gardens. Rome 8:31, which we all know, if God be for us, who can be against us? And it has proven since 1932. We believing in Rome 8:31, we cannot go wrong. And we go into new ventures, and we have this privilege sharing it with you. And we just have to mention, and we want to acknowledge the presence of our president of Eastern Province Rugby, Mr. Raderman, with us. We just also see that the president of our sub-union, Mr. January, also just entered with his executive member, Mr. Marman, which is also a member of Gardens. And the executive want everyone to just enjoy this moment. As I say, it's something new. It is something that we're going to learn. We're going to make mistakes in this process, but we're going to get it right. Also tonight, we have to acknowledge also the presence of Mr. Bantwini amongst us. Yes, there was a lot of issues around who you invite and who you call. But for us as Gardens, we're thinking about rugby. Politics in rugby have the platform to sort itself out. But for us, it all goes about the fact it is rugby that we're going to enjoy tonight. In a program that we wish going to be the start of something great to come. Also tonight, amongst ourselves, we can never forget about our legends. Mr. White Boys, the White Boy Brothers, Mr. Korkia, Omron. When I was listening to the message, which both of you, all of you going to hear later, of Mr. Smuts from Japan, then he talk about you guys. We are still have the privilege to be with you guys, listen to you guys. But now, with the launch of this website, we don't want only us to know it, but we want the world to know it. We want those who are not here in Utnik. Now they will have the opportunity, not only when they're speaking to people about Gardens, they can say, bring your phone, let me open Gardens website and let me show you who is Gert Whiteboy. Let me show you who is Ronnie Korkia, and let me show you who is the legends of Gardens Rugby. And I think that is the purpose of the launching of this website, to educate not only Gardens supporters, but to educate the rugby public outside there about Gardens as the rugby club it is. Now, when we started as this executive, it was very clear to us. We are running a race, and when you're an athletic, you know you must stay in your lane. As our president also say, he's the president. He have his lane is running in. You are the vice, you have your lane you're running in. Now, I have to acknowledge the presence of our coaches here. And here I want to throw now the challenge to yourself as coaches and me, myself as the senior vice. We have to look after coaches and senior players' affairs within the club. The president and the rest of the team, with Daniel and with Clarence, the marketing, and Mr. Hobbs, the secretary, Mr. Boy, and all of the rest of the guys, they have done now the job of start marketing Gardens, the brand of Gardens. And we've always said we never recognize the value of our brand. But now, coaches and myself, for that brand to go out in the world, we have to let the performance on the field speak to what we are doing tonight. It's a big challenge. But I believe with myself and you guys, and what we have to our disposal of players, we can back them up and let this brand go further, Mr. Press, and that we work very hard on it. And we come from a disease that have rippled the world, that have killed the world, that have bring everything down to abnormality. We are not used to it. It's the first time in our lifetime that we have seen something like this. And just maybe that we have to stand up for a moment, 1 minute of silence, because Gardens from COVID-19 started in December of 2019. There was times that me and the press were one time saying that maybe we must taking our camping chairs and just sit at the graveyard and wait for all the funerals to come. We have lost legends in this time. The Mafits. If you go around and mention the names, I think it will do unjust, Omgeer, because you can just maybe miss one name and it can cause a lot of... But we have missed legends. We have lost them through COVID. So just for a few seconds of silence, can we just stand up and just bow our heads? Thank you. Then, also we have to welcome and acknowledge the vice chairperson of our supporters club, which Mr. Marman, which is another challenge for you guys at the supporters club, because currently Gardens, if we look at our Facebook page, we have about 10,000. So the supporters club must reflect what is our membership and what is our following. So for us, we will see, or like to see the supporters club grow. We should like to see every member is becoming a member of the supporters club. And becoming a member of the supporters club, you automatically bend yourself to being a member of Gardens and stick to the rules of Gardens. And it is just nice, and I know the players like it, coaches know it, where they go, when they see the green machine follow. And I can openly say that we are maybe the most supported team wherever we go in our away games. And just keep up the good work. Now, to our supporters who follow us on the Facebook page, who cannot be here with us, we know a lot of you may not be happy, Mr. Prince. There's a lot of people who also wanted to enjoy the night with us. But because of COVID-19, because of regulations, we cannot let this event stand over. We have to go forward. And by launching the website, it is a step that we want to go and that we want to make sure wherever Gardens is going to play, if the spectators are not allowed to be in the field, we as the executive will make sure that we will bring the game to you through this website, through our live Facebook page, and then you guys can just be happy assured that you can sit at the comfort at your homes, you can still watch the boys playing. Believe me, if you scream hard enough in Utnek, we will hear you in the field when we are there. So, everyone welcome, everyone present here welcome, everyone who joined us on Facebook, everyone wherever you are, welcome to this historic night and just enjoy it with us. Be a greens for once tonight, everyone who's here, and just have a lovely night. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Senior Vice. We now call on the president of Gardens Rugby, Mr. Royden Johnson, to just give us a brief reason behind this website launch.
Thank you, Thank you, Mr. Marman. First of all, like Rudy said, welcome all of you. Just a brief history on the website launch. When we took over, it was turbulent times for us as a club. I can remember one guy making the joke and saying we'll probably go down as being the leadership with the worst winning record, because when we started, we lost 5 games on the trot. So when COVID came, we actually thought, what can we do different as a club? And for me personally, it was always a problem that you hear bits and pieces of our history, but there's nothing concrete where you can go to. And each and everyone has got his or her story. So we came up with the idea to actually use it as a marketing tool to start to tell our history, to tell our story, so that the world can know. And I'm always passionate because we've got a long history dating back to 1932, and especially 1991 with amalgamation, the fact that we went against the decision and we had turbulent times after that. So I just felt that it was a history that needs to be told for everybody, that is a gardens, and not only gardens, but for the world to see. And what you're going to see tonight is still ever evolving, because there's still some pieces that we need to put together so that we can have a complete message about gardens. And like I say, we have one of the strongest brands with regards to following, not only in the Eastern Cape, but in the country. And our numbers can speak for ourselves. With 10,000 members on Facebook, we're always interactive. And now is the opportunity for the people to see and to actually get a glimpse of what it was like starting this wonderful club. So I hope that you guys will enjoy the journey with us. As I said, it's going to be ever evolving. We don't know what the future holds with regards to information and what we're going to put out there. But rest assured that the name Gardens will forever be remembered long after we are gone. Thank you, Mr. Marman.
Thank you, Mr. President. We now call on the President of Eastern Province to just give us his blessing for the evening and for the website, and I think he will wish us well in this endeavor. Thank you, Mr. Raderman.
MC, thank you very much. The President of Gardens, your executive, and everybody here present tonight. Believe me, it's a privilege for me being here tonight. And I want to start off by saying this. For me, addressing you tonight is an honor. If I look at Gardens through the years with progress and the clubs here in Uitenhage, you are really probably the foundation of rugby in Eastern Province. And if you look at the talent and grassroots rugby, and I always make the joke that if we go back in what happened in 2019, the Eastern Cape won the World Cup. If you look at the coaching staff, they all come from Uitenhage and Dispatch. Yeah. If you look at the players, Magazola Mapimpi, Lokanyo Am, if you look at Sia Kulisi, Elton Yankees, they're all from this, all from the Eastern Cape. And what does that tell us? Grassroots rugby, that's where it starts. That is where it all starts. And at the end of the day, when we liquidated the Kings, and a lot of people said, I'm going to go down in history as the man that killed the Kings, it is fine. I will bear that brunt. The Kings were never our brand. And the first time in our history, you probably saw what's happening now, Eastern Province is playing the Blue Bulls at Loftus. Eastern Province playing the Lions in our own stadium. We're playing Griquas next Wednesday. We're playing the Cheetahs. We're back in the mainstream. And I think a lot of people and my executive must be applauded for that. We fought a hard battle for the last 4 years. But where does it start? Grassroots rugby. We must start to keep our primary school players, our high school players, and our club structure strong, because that's where our talent lies. We must make our club strong, because that is where it all starts. That's the foundation. That's grassroots rugby. And if you look at the present, what's happening at the moment with Peter de Villiers, if you look at the squad that he's putting together, it's Progress, it's Gardens, it's Harlequins, it's club players. Did we lose at Loftus 87-10? Yes, we did. And I don't want to find excuses, but I want to say this to you. We played 2019 the last time rugby. Number two is club players, amateur players. Number three, if you look at the Blue Bulls, that's the most strongest union in the country at the moment. They got a 70 million rand budget. We got a 2 million rand budget for the year. And if you look at how our players excelled, 87-10, yes, fine. We were thrown in by the deep side. It's the first time our coach saw the players playing together. He didn't know them. He came from the Cape. He's got no clue. He was given a squad. That's the first game. The second game, he made 7 changes. We played the Lions here. The second minute, we got a red card. I'm still my own opinion about red card, but I don't want to say much. It'll be in the media probably, or social media. Everything I say these days is on social media. But it's ridiculous. And what happens then? We play with 13 men and we lose. With 10 minutes to go, I think the score was 33-24. And then they scored 3 tries and we lost with a score that is not really a picture of what happened in the game. Why did this happen? 13 players against 15. You can't, there's a coach sitting. You can't just keep closing holes and yeah. But I'm very proud of the boys. We signed UXI. It is a academy. They already notified me they've got 100 bursaries for players. Because what do we want to do? We don't want to just play rugby. What happens to a rugby player? It's got a very short lifespan. He leaves school, primary school, high school, and he leaves school. What happens to him then? He plays club rugby and maybe a provincial game or two. He gets injured or so forth, or what? He gets lost in the mix. You never hear from him again. Why is UXI coming to the forefront? They've got 100 bursaries that they are sponsoring. They wait, the contract is signed. Why is that? We want to play rugby. After the rugby, that bursaries, we want to send people into the world that makes a success of their life, but their foundation was rugby. They become plumbers, electricians, boilermakers, whatever you want to call it. We are busy at the moment. We'll sit very, probably the next 2 weeks, we'll sit with the municipality, with the old Blue Stadium, who knows where it is, opposite St. George's Park, where we are going into an agreement with the municipality between the UXI, that's going to be our academy, Crusader Rugby Club, and the cricket club, to form a joint MOU with the municipality on a long term, and that is where we want to host the UXI Academy. That's going to be a big thing for us going forward. I just spoke about the World Cup, and I spoke of where we're going from here. And where does it all start? Club rugby. EPRU at the moment is at the tipping point. The first four years since this administration took over from first Cheeky Watson and then the administration that was in 1 year, 4 years was just building this union, fixing up problems, one stumbling from one problem to the next. That's factual. When we took over, we had 31 rand in the bank for a union. We had no voting rights. Un-administration, un-liquidation, and the list just goes on. At the moment, these problems are all sorted. Do we have our own internal problems? Yes, we have, like any institution in this country. But don't let that divide us. We are now at the tipping point. why, what's happening. We're in negotiations with the municipality. Today I was informed that the 6 million rand that they're giving us has been paid over. We are in a winning situation at the moment. I can nearly guarantee you we'll get the vote in the SARU General Council to go into Premium Division, and that will be a big booster for us. It's from First Division, that's a 12 million rand budget, to Premium Division, that's a 19.2 million rand budget. We're sitting with other proposals we're busy with, and also with a sponsorship committee. Very professional businessmen sitting now with us around the table say, okay, if we can enhance stability and we can show that we are there for rugby, taking this union forward, they will start coming to the party, they'll sit around the table with us. And that is the things we must start doing. I think the person that opened this meeting spoke about unity. That is very important. It's absolutely important. When we took office, we spoke about the Cheeky Watson group and the new group, and I see that is again happening in our union, starting to divide us. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not yet to seek any honor. I'm not yet to seek any praises for what happened in the last 4 years. And I take everything that comes my way. If you want to criticize me, it's fine. Come and sit in my chair and do the job. Then you can criticize me. We are on our own now. The whole world is looking at EP Rugby Union at the moment. The whole world. The business world is looking at us. And if I can do one thing, is to unify this province and this union, EPR Rugby Union, we will be successful. We will. And like the gentleman said, a house divided, the Bible says it is weak. A house that stands together is strong. Now, I want to say this, I want to tell a little story. I heard your sermon just now. I come out of a house where my grandfather was a pastor. My youngest son is a pastor. And I'm not going to talk about the Bible because I think that that's something for another time. But I want to say this to you. I once heard a little story about a frog that was in a well at the bottom, playing in the water. And he was very happy, extremely happy. And there was big rains coming and the well swelled up. At such a point where the little frog came on top of the wall of the well, and he looked and he saw a dam. And he jumped to the dam and he thought, well, this is heaven now, I'm in the dam. Look at all this water. And another storm came, another floods, and he ended up in the ocean. And he said, wow, look at this. And if you can read between the lines, that's EP Rugby Union. Don't let us stay in the well. We're out of the well. We're at the dam now. But the sea is awaiting us. If we can unite and forget personal agendas, and we can start building a union for rugby, that's the thing. Nothing else. We will be successful. And I believe in my heart, I believe it, that we can take this union to be in the top five in South Africa. The Bulls, Stormers, Sharks, Lions, their budget is enormous. And if we turn around and we just take our talent, just our talent, and our God-given talent and expertise within our own fraternity, we can take this union in the top five and we can compete and we can even beat them. I told Willem Strauss when I sat with him in the Blue Bulls game, Willem, my biggest dream is to bring a team onto this field, the EP team. Transformation. But people like Lakanyu Am, Makazola Mapimpi, and beat you on this field. And I know in my heart, we can do it. I know it. I believe it. Otherwise, we wouldn't stand here. I would have left long ago. So I want to end off by saying this, gentlemen, I always got an open door policy. Always. I've never let anybody down. If you disregard me or differ with me, pick up a phone, come to my office, come talk to me. And then we'll find solutions together. And I do believe, Gardens, thank you. Your website tonight is phenomenal. What you are doing is phenomenal. You are one of the top clubs in our province. And you know what? We need this. We need these top clubs. We need clubs with own websites, strong teams playing. And I want to end off by saying this. The Kings played in the stadium. There was 2,000 people in the stadium. The same day Progress Gardens played 15,000 people in the stadium. That's how strong our club rugby is. Now that is why I spoke to Celtics, and they prepared to sponsor the next derby between the two teams. And I wish you well. You are a very proud rugby club. You are one of our custodians. You are one of our benchmarks. That's why I'm here tonight. Just to say to you, I'm proud of you. Keep on with the good work. Assist me. One man can't do it. Just impossible. You can't do it. Let's take hands. Let's build. And a chain is as strong as every link in that chain. If one link is weak, that chain is weak. So let's build that chain. I thank you very much. May God bless you. Stay safe. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Raderman. I would just like to refer to the word unity, especially our late president, Mr. Paul Sekwi. And he always spoke about unity and the Ten Commandments. And when this club was established, Christianity was one of the main purposes. And we've heard a lot about all the players that came through the ranks since 1932. And we've got a rich history. And I think that the website will be the ideal platform to reflect that history. I would like to acknowledge the presence of Mr. Van Willen, who came in late. Thank you for coming, Junior. But I've heard about Chani Labat and Gal Boonaparte. I saw Gert Whiteboy and Dan Kayser. I saw Farouk, Isaacs, Ronnie Corkier, Eric Sauls, Roy Dessel, Ron Reed, Ivan van Staden. I saw a drop goal from a hooker called Ernest Magwa. And up to the year that we broke through on the Putty Rasmus Stadium with a try of Melvin Killian against Olympics. And Mr. Chair, Mr. President of Eastern Province, the history is just coming and coming and coming. And I remember when we had the meeting, the unity meeting at Verity Primary that evening, a lot of people were heartbroken that we had to take that decision to stay on his gardens. And I think, Mr. Korkia, we made the right decision that evening by, not unanimously, by majority vote. And we said that we'll fight our way to the top. And we played in every league, town league and city league, and Mickey Healy, and call them what you like. We played them and we won them and we are here where we are today. And I would like to actually just stand still for a moment and look at the past 9-10 years, since 2008-2009. In 2009, we won that inaugural Super 12 competition of four clubs from Border, four from EP and four from SBD. We won that one. And since then, we've won that Super Rugby competition a lot of times with various coaches. And Mr. Gert Whiteboy always said, only gardens can beat gardens. And we saw that for the past 2 years, that only gardens can beat gardens. So from now on, with the initiatives of the present executive, we can just go forward. As one of our legends, the late Pruitt Williams, Brandon Williams, said, "Vorentoe." There's no other way, just forward. Mr. President of Gardens will explain now to us the QR code donation, the QR code donation of this website.
Okay, once again, thank you, Mr. Marman. For clearance in the team, after this we'll play the video clips. With regards to the QR code, as we know that club rugby at a club level is not sustainable if there's no finances. And when I took over as president, one of the biggest issues I had was that it's difficult to be sustainable if there's no cash flow. So what we have done as a club, because I knew that we had a strong brand as a club, if I look at our supporters, we've actually came up with a QR code whereby if you visit our website, you can scan our QR code and that will immediately take you to our banking details. And on our banking details, there's different subcategories whereby you can donate. So what I want to do is actually get the community to sustain us by keeping us on the field. I can remember years ago, when I was still playing, we would still pay for our own taxi fare. We would still pay for our own transport. And this one particular day, I did not have enough. I think I was short about 6 or 7 rand. And I can remember the late Mabella collecting, and he said, with all due respect, "Only JC ever run short." And at that particular time, my auntie was walking by, and she gave the 7 rand to Mr. Mabella. And I got into the taxi. But then I saw the auntie did not go in. She turned around. And that made me think that miskien het sy 'n brood kom koop of melk kom koop. And she turned around, she went back, she said, "Niks gaan koop as jy wil." And that's where it came in that we are a community club. So you'll go to our QR code, you'll scan, and you will donate towards gardens. And like I said, there's different subcategories like player development, player affairs. If I might use an example, one of our biggest initiatives, especially for our player development, is to make sure that there's no player playing for gardens that don't have license. License is a critical skill nowadays, especially if you want a job. So if we want to send 10 guys, we will rely on our support to say, "Okay, right, can you please donate towards this initiative?" And I know if we use the community, we will be able to sustain ourselves. One of my biggest gripes with club rugby is that we are catering for 1% of professional players. What are we doing to the 99? I'm one of the guys that ended up back in the industrial world. So a lot of our guys that's going back into the community, a lot of taxi drivers, they become operators, ambulance drivers, they become doctors, they become lawyers. So 99% does not go on to play professional rugby. So we need to find other means. And when we went out for sponsors, I said, "I'm not good at this thing." To actually go, instead of going and asking a 10,000, I would ask 10,000 people for 1 rand. And like I say, when we lost our first 5 games, I said to Rudy, that it's your KPI that they are messing with. Because when I look at the gate takings, it's still the same, regardless if we win or lose. And as president, keep me accountable for sponsors that come aboard, keep me accountable for what's in the bank, because that's my job as a president. At the moment, your KPI is looking very bad because you're sitting with five losses. And like I say, and if I might quote what Harlequin's president said to me, he said to me that, Mr. Press, you are in a fortunate position that if Harlequins loses two games, the Ad Hoc is leeg. But I know if Gardens loses, I know the likes of Dala Marman, they're going to say what they say in the stand, but I'm certain about his 20 rand coming to Gardens. So that's why I say we've got loyal supporters, and we will send out more information around the QR code because it's actually a brilliant thing, not only for a club, but even for a province, whereby we can be able to sustain ourselves. You go onto our website, you scan, or maybe we can try tonight afterwards, if you want to really know how it works, Junior, Mr. Korkia, whoever, Mr. Radaman, if you really want to know how it works, I can actually give you an example, a physical example, going into the QR code, scanning and donating. So basically, that's all I wanted to say around the QR code. Like I say, we are going to continuously put out information because I know that we have a strong club and we will be able to sustain ourselves. Thank you very much.
Die videoclips recht, mannen. Videoclips.
Leave them all in the dust. Got a Cadillac six-pack vision of us. Tonight we ride high into the desert sky. Hands up, feel the heat in the air. Legends never die, they play truth or dare. Tonight we stop time, let go of the wheel and drive. How does it feel to fly? We are the stars that shine. We don't need any. Leave them all in the dust. Got a Cadillac six-pack vision of us. Tonight we ride high into the desert sky. Hands up, feel the heat in the air. Legends never die, they play truth or dare. Tonight we stop time, let go of the wheel and drive. How does it feel to fly? We are the stars that shine. We don't even have to try. We could go down in flames, but we'll melt the world away. All I know is you're my rock and roll, and wherever we go, we are heroes, heroes. They don't make them like you and I. Legends never die. Together, I know we will
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, lady and gentlemen, that was just a tip of what gardens, the rich history that gardens actually is and have. We also very diverse, and we are a family. I remember one of the players, these illnesses of blood pressure and diabetes, and when you don't have medical aid, then Pa will tell someone that have medical, just get something there for brood. You know, they don't have a medical aid, and that is how we sort each other out. Because the hooker is a manager, an area manager of a big retail company. The prop is a policeman, and the other one is unemployed. And after a few years, then we have another prop that is working as a someone that cutting the grass of people, looking for work all the time. And then we have a teacher, and then we have someone that's working and getting good money from Goodyear. But we catered for all of them. As a family, we looked after each other. I remember we went in 2009, we went to Groot Brak to play against Barbarians. Yeah? We played against Groot Brak, but we stayed in Mossel Bay. And when we stopped at a garage with a shop, then people knew that Gordon will sort out those few guys that don't have money. And that person will sort out those. And that is how we looked as a team after each other. That is the history of Gardens. We will now have a message from the president of SARU, Mr. Mark Alexander.
Good evening. Gardens was formed on a Sunday in 1932 by a group of dedicated churchmen operating from Blikkiesdorp, where the club is still based today. Uitenhage was affectionately known as the Garden Town, hence the oak tree as on the club emblem. Gardens is synonymous with rugby in the Uitenhage district of the Eastern Province. And the club was a major force in the Eastern Cape region since it was formed in 1932. As in the case with so many clubs from the old non-racial SARU fold, the era before unification, the clubs has a rich history and influencing culture in the society that it represents. It was always a family club, with the Kokiers, the Sauls, the Witboy brothers, and many others representing established families in the area. Well-known players produced by the club include Yanni Damans, Yanni Lebet from the 50s era, Dan Kayser, the father of Springbok Dion Kayser, Eric Sauls and Ronnie Kokia. Ronnie Kokia and Eric Sauls went on to play for Uitenhage and District and as well for SARU. To understand the history and the influence of Gardens in its surrounding areas and the broader South African rugby context. It is perhaps important to pause and reflect once more on the often neglected impact of club and school rugby on the basic fabric of our society. Club and school rugby is without doubt the backbone of South African rugby. The lifeblood and the oxygen that our rugby needs to breathe, to develop and to perform. Since the fight for equal rights in South Africa, club rugby, in every far-flung rural corner of our vast country, has established itself as one of the key fabric components of our society. Take away clubs and school rugby, and in many instances you will unplug the community from its society and the sporting lifeline and the game they love. Then, for various days during the week, the clubhouse is a beehive of activity. Club meetings and gatherings, and many times this very infrastructure is used to fulfill the basic need of the closely knit community. Similarly, the social and wellness aspect of a well-run club cannot be underestimated. An era where players and young and old apply their trade. And Gardens is such a club. Steeped in the tradition was a history of delivering quality players to Uitenhek, to Eastern Province, and at various national levels, players and coaches likewise. On behalf of the South African Rugby Union, I want to salute Gardens. Well done on your achievements so far. My best of luck for the many years that will still come. I thank you.
We are almost through with the program. We now have a vote of thanks from Tandile Vogel. The vote of thanks.
Evening, everyone. On behalf of our leadership team, I would like to say a heartfelt thank you to everyone that has taken the time to share this momentous occasion with us, our virtual audience, as well as you sitting here. Mr. Rademan, President of EP Rugby, Dennis January, Sub-Union Chairman, and all our special guests, including Mr. Matika and Mr. Johannes. I would like our chairman to say thank you to all our sponsors.
Ek maar die geld gedeeltjie doen. Yeah, when we started out, and correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. Hobbs, I think we had about 97 potential sponsors, but we only went to about 5 of them because the expenses for this was not that much. And we said to the likes of Junior, we only need 2% of what you're actually going to sponsor us. So most of the sponsors gave 2%, and we're still going to the other 95. I would like to say thank you to Dr. Williams and Mr. Benny Fredericks. I would like to say thank you to Buco, Mr. Morne Mars, Dr. Peters, Gamble Pharmacy, Pele Pele Investments, and Mr. Van Willen, and as well as to YND Sports. As we know that as a club, it's not easy to run a club, so we need businesses on board. We need individual contributions. And that was one of the reasons that we actually went the QR code way. Like I say, it's an interesting method, and there's a lot of internal controls because we do have people that actually wants to give back.
And I want to say special thanks to our leadership team for the effort that they've put in. Without you, this would have been possible. I always say that I don't think that I'm equipped or competent to be the president. And it's not a reflection of my ability, but it's just the fact that Gardens is a big club. Gardens is an extraordinary club that was built on the shoulders of ordinary men. And I know going forward that with the grace of God, we will be successful. I know what we have ventured into, people are going to get on board. And like I say, we don't have to wait. We can sustain ourselves as a club and go forward and make sure that one day when our players look back that they have become men in the process. Thank you very much. Over to you, Mr. Marman.
Our last item. Manager, I like that so as of once you've to honey. Our last item is the closing prayer by one of the first team coaches, Mr. Jerome Bosch.
Goeie naand allemaal. Op meneer Marman, meneer Rademan verstaan Afrikaans. Voor ik die gebed gaan doen, is er net twee goede wat ik net goed wil vertel. Meneer Marman het net toe gepraat van Melville Kilian, sy 3-10 Olympics. Maar allemaal celebreit. Die traai, wanneer is die wen traai. Maar in die middel van Boetie Rasmus, by die treinse kant, is ek in die moeilikheid, Kevin, met die grote bewaarderslot van Olympics. En die man wil my afransel. Daar is niemand rondom my nie. Maar die volgende oomblik, toe my plaas denke, hier kom, toe staan ek met die toks in die hand. En die geveg was onmiddellik oor. Die tweede een is 2001 in Kirkwoodse plaaslike hospitaal. My moeder was in die hospitaal destijds en al die groot manne het die hospitaal doorgekom haai aan. Het was die voorbeeld wat hulle gestel het. Hulle was eindelijk meer as Kirkwoodse mense daar by die hospitaal en allemaal het een gebed gedoen en sy het hulle teruggeroep. Om Pila was haar so, om Derek Ferreira, om Wieteron, om Sunny Boy, hulle, allemaal was teenwoordig gewees. En sy sê vir hulle, daar is my kind, ek gee hom nou oor aan julle, kyk mooi na hom, en tot vandag toe nog, kan ek met trots praat, van hierdie Gardens. Kom ons bid saam. Onse Vader, Here wat in die hemele is, Here Jesus, baie dankie, Here genade kans, Here het die hande eet, Here wat u my gee, Here om met u te kan praat, Here. Here het die begeertes, Here gehoor, Here van die president, van OP Rugby, Here, baie dankie dat ek weet dat u daar die begeertes, Here sal waar maak, Here. Here, want die Bybel verklaar, ek gaan self vooruit, Here, om hoogtes gelyk te maak, Here. Here, lei om, Here, vou om toe, Here, Here, nie holte van die hand. Here, dat u sal weet, Here, dat u sy vertroue in u, Here, sal sit, en dat hy nie op sy eie inzichte sal staart maak nie, Here. Here, hier is ons as Gardens. Here, oor 30, 40 jaar, Here, sal ons nie meer op die aarde wees nie. Maar ek weet, omdat ons een levendige God aanbid het, Here, Here, en die stichters van die klap, Here, weet ek, Here, die klap sal nog staan, Here, tot in lengte van daar. Here, tot wanneer u, Here, sal kom, Here om te kom haal wanneer wat u sinne is, Here. Baie dankie, Here, vir elke boodskap wat uitgegaan het, Here. Here sponsors, Here, wat ingekom het, Here, ek bid en ek pleit, Here, dat u, Here, hulle besighede sal seën, Here, in Jesus naam, Here. Here Jesus, dat hulle goeie werke, Here, nie ongesiens, Here, sal verbygaan, Here. Ek bid vanaand, Here, ek dra ons as spelers, Here, voor die voete neer, Here Jesus. Here, ek dra ons spelers, ouers, Here, Here, wat hulle instuur rugby toe, Here, dat u hulle ook sal seën, Here. Here, kom sny af, Here, wat hinderlik en skadelik is, Here, in die naam van Jesus, Here. Here, hier is ons executive, Here, jonk, Here, in die broek, Here, maar met u aan ons kant, Here, weet ek, Here, Here, dat ons hoogtes gaan bereik, Here. Ek bid, Here, Here, dat hulle ons nie teen mekaar sal werk nie. Here, maar wat ons deur die waar deur die drif saam sal trek, Here. Here, wanneer hulle goed iets goed deurkom, dat hulle ons nie sal sê dat ek dit gedoen het nie. Of ek het dat gedoen, of ek het dat gedoen nie. Maar ons sal weet, Here, ons, te saam met die Here, Here, het ons hier deurgedra, Here. Sien alles, Here, wat nog gedoen sal word, in Jesus naam. Amen.
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, dat ons net iets uitgelos. I think Smuts Ngonyama from Kwano Bushle. He is the ambassador of South Africa in Japan. And I think he also sent us a message that we will play now. And after that, we will have the blessing, Mr. Whiteboy.
Greetings to you, Mr. President Royden Johnson, the president of Gardens Rugby Football Club of Udeg, that was born in 1952. It's a special one because I share the same year of birth with Gardens Rugby Football Club. I can say that Gardens Football Club is not an ordinary rugby club, and therefore I congratulate it on this very important day on the launch of its website. Because Gardens Rugby Football Club could be rated as one of the greatest football club, not only in Uitenhage, Eastern Province, but also in South Africa as a whole. It is one of the greatest clubs because of the quality of its administration, as organized by dedicated men and women. And that is why even today we still talk of Groen Gardens Rugby Football Club, a club that has produced so many people. It is one of the greatest clubs because of the quality of its style of rugby in the field of play. Oh, it's a great pleasure to watch Groen, as it is affectionately called by many of its fans and many of us that know the club and appreciate its rugby. I grew up in Uitenhage.
Okay, Mr. Whiteboy, let us see in this belief.
Kom ons ontvang die seën van die Here en ons bly in sy vrede. Noem op die genade van ons Here Jesus Christus, die liefde van God ons Vader en die troostvolle gemeenskap van sy Heilige Gees, rus en bly, Here, en veral met die klap, dat dit gaan ten hoogtes tot hoogtes, in Jesus naam. Amen.
O ja, weer eens baie dankie en ons sal graag wil hê dat van julle moet achterblij een paar foto's neem en ons sal nou bedien word met ete. Dat ons intermingel en soos ek sê, ons is hier vir rugby. Ons is hier vir onze jong manne en jong vrouwe wat hulle levens op die spel sit. En dat ons het eer. Weer eens, baie dankie allemaal. Green is my valley and red is my heart. Gardens for life. Amen.
En het kom op by die fouters. Dit is maar smaak klaar luister maar die pas word dit nie te ver van die hele kom.